I've got this basic web page, which I've applied a few CSS styles to. Here's what the web page looks like. Let's say I want to highlight the first two paragraphs about the foods that I like in a bluish box. Looking at the HTML, I can see that those two paragraphs are surrounded by the P tags. So I'll put in a style applied to the P tag, and let's say the background color of that will be cyan. We'll save it and refresh. Now I've got two problems that happened here. Not only did the two paragraphs that I wanted get highlighted, there was also a third paragraph right above the list that also got highlighted. I didn't want that one to have a blue box. And the second problem was I actually wanted one blue box around both paragraphs, not the paragraphs individually. So I can't do it this way. I can't apply a style to the P tags because it grabs too many of them. The solution there is to surround the two paragraphs that I'm interested in with kind of like a box. And to create that box, I use the div tag. So I'll put an opening and closing around the two paragraphs I'm interested in, and then I can apply a style just to the div tag. I'll say div background color cyan, save it, and refresh the page, and then I get one blue box around those two paragraphs. That's what I wanted. Now let's say I also want to surround the bottom part with the favorites list in a box of a different color. So I can create a box around those elements with another div tag. But then I've got a problem here. Let's save it and refresh, and we see that we end up with two boxes that are highlighted both in cyan, but I want that bottom box to be a different color. The problem here is that the div style applies to all the div tags, and I want them to be different. The way CSS solves this problem is by allowing you to assign a unique name to tags that makes them distinguishable from each other. For the first tag, I'm going to say class equals food, and for the second tag, I'll say class equals faves. So the first div has the name food, and the second div has the name faves. And then in the style section, I can say dot food, and that applies to the first div. And then dot faves with its background color. And I'll just make up a color here like C9, F1, 98 with a hash mark in front. And we'll save that. Refresh it, and then I see that both boxes have been colored separately from each other, and that's what I wanted. So the div tag allows you to surround multiple elements on the page with what is essentially a box, and then style each box separately. And you do that by assigning a name using this class attribute to the div. Give it a name, and then in your CSS style section, you put in the name of the tag with a dot in front of it, and then you can style it like you would any other tag.